loves and welcome back to my channel. Today I am ranking handbag materials from most to least durable. Now this is in my own personal experience of owning and using handbags for many, many years. So I'm gonna kind of get into which leathers I think are great for daily use, and the more delicate ones, I'll give some tips on how to care for them if you still want to add them to your collection. And by the way, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I make videos about luxury handbags, fashion, and lifestyle. So if that's your thing, please subscribe and turn on notifications. I upload twice a week. Well, I try to. I would love to have you join me here. Let's just get into my most to least durable handbag leathers and fabrics. Starting off with Louis Vuitton canvas. I really find this to be the most durable material for designer bags. Now, the only thing you have to look out for is when they do these with the vachetta leather, it is going to patina, but a lot of their canvas pieces are trimmed in the black leather, so you don't get that patina look, and I think those are more durable than the vachetta leather for sure. But in terms of daily use, you could not be more carefree than a Louis Vuitton canvas. I mean, you can run your nails on it, you could put this on the floor, which I don't recommend, but if you did, this is really gonna stand the test of time. It's not really gonna get a whole lot of wear marks. It's quite difficult to damage a Louis Vuitton canvas. Like, you really have to try. So this, I really feel, even above like a grained leather, is one of the most durable materials you can get for a designer handbag. And it's so perfect for daily use. Next material on my list is coated leather. So this is a leather that has some type of treatment on it. This was a new leather for the Gucci Kin Scott collection. It's a coated leather. Really make sure that the design stays put, but also it adds a level of like durability. Like, again, you can scratch this, nothing happens. The only drawback to this that I would say is that it does make the bag more stiff. So I think this only really works for particular styles. Like, it looks really great with this type of bag. But if you were having a more relaxed shape of bag, I don't think it would work, and I think that's why we don't see these like coated leathers as frequently. Something that would take a lot more effort to hunt down as well, because typically you just have like your canvas option or like grained or smooth leather options. So I think that this is a very particular type of leather and more difficult to find. But I think it's one that if you're looking for a more special piece, like this one is like a painted kind of version, this is gonna make the design last longer. So you really wanna look into that if you're gonna get a bag with a design on it. Next type of leather on my list is croc embossed leather. I put this one above grain leather because I really feel like croc embossed is one that really hides scratches well. Typically when there's croc embossed, there is some type of treatment to the leather as well. You see kind of a shine finish to it. That treatment also adds to the durability of the leather. It's usually some type of coating. So those teeny tiny minor nicks, you don't see show up as much on croc embossed leather, which is not always the case with grained leather. There's not always that same type of coating on it. So I really think that for a daily use bag, it also makes the bag look a little more special, and it's something more unique that if you get a classic shape in a croc embossed leather, I think it's a really great durable option that's also a little different. Next leather on my list is grained or caviar leather. Depending on the brand, they will call this different things, but basically it's any leather that has some type of texture to it. Texture to a leather hides scratches better. So if you're gonna plan to buy a designer bag for daily use, a grained leather is definitely a great way to go. They're usually still quite supple and last many, many years, but also give you that durability of hiding little marks and nicks that you're gonna get with daily use. A lot of people don't think about the fact that you're using a designer handbag. It's not always gonna look like it was brand new on the shelf. It's definitely my leather of choice for Chanel as well. If I wanna get a bag that's going to last me decades and I'm gonna use it quite frequently, caviar is always the way that I go. I try to avoid lambskin actually quite a bit. I think their older pieces really hold up well, but colorful pieces especially, I really recommend a grain leather. Next leather on my list is patent leather. Some people call it patent, doesn't really matter. Patent leather is quite a durable material. Now, there are some pros and cons to patent leather, and I wanna be very clear on this. If you live in a hot climate, I really don't recommend a lot of patent in your collection. You need to condition it often and get cracking after a few years. So I've kind of phased out most of the patent in my collection. I have this one and one other bag remaining, and this one I make sure to condition every 6 months at least, and I keep it in a temperature controlled room. But patent leather is one that if you're wearing it on a night out and you spill something, you can wipe it off easily. Black is probably the way to go in patent because colors, if you get color transfer on there, you cannot clean it off. It gets set underneath the treatment of the patent and there's no way to remove it. So that was the biggest mistake of my first Chanel mini I ever had was a teal patent. I didn't really know how to care for designer bags when I got that bag. There wasn't, you know, YouTube and Instagram and tips and tricks and things like that. So I definitely got color transfer on the back of it and I have sold that bag on now and I lost a lot of money on it because it wasn't in good shape. So if you're gonna buy patent leather in a color, you need to be very careful about color transfer. But in terms of wearing it out, I wore that mini out to death. That was during my partying days, going out in New York. No issues in that respect. So if you care for patent properly, it's a really great leather. If you're in that phase of your life, especially where you're going out a lot and you need something that's just kind of worry-free, patent is so great. When I lived in the US, I had no issues with my patent leather bags. I highly recommend it, especially if you live in a cold climate. Patent is a great leather to go for, but I had to put it lower on the list because of those issues with like color transfer on colorful patent bags and because it doesn't work for every climate. Next material on my list is nylon. Now, nylon is just that like workhorse type of material. It's scratch resistant, it's like weatherproof pretty much, or at least weather resistant for most brands. It's one of those carefree type of materials. Not too much risk of tearing this material because it's quite strong and quite durable, but if you did get like a pull in it or a tear or something like that, it's one of those that there's not much saving it. So I put it under a lot of like grained leathers and those kind of things, because there's not much you can do to repair a nylon versus what they can do at like a leather surgeon's for leather. I think nylon is one that if you have that more casual style and you live in specific climates, it's honestly can be better than getting a leather bag, but I don't think it's great for all occasions. I also would especially be cautious with colorful nylon because if you got a really set in stain, it depends on what type of bag spas you have around you and like what you can really do to clean the nylon. Because if you maybe got like a coffee stain set in or something like that, I'd be afraid that you might not be able to get it out. The next material I have on my list is like this metallic coated leather. This is one that can really vary from brand to brand. I have not had any issues with this, and because it has like the crinkled pattern in it, you can't notice any marks. Like, I don't think I've even gotten a mark on this bag, like when I look it over. But even if I had, it would be really hard to tell if it's like a small mark. If you get a deep scratch on this, you're really gonna notice it. So you wanna be careful in that respect. Because it is a treatment on top as well, I find that like when I touch it, it's a little bit like more weatherproof than like a lambskin. I think this one is a great option to go for, but you have to be careful in a sense that like you don't wear this with denim and things like that where it like rubs against it and you rub off this finish. But if you're just wearing this with like dresses and soft fabrics, this is a great bag. It's in the middle of my list for a reason. It's like durable for the more special type of bags, but it's less durable than like a daily use type of bag. The next material I have on my list is tweed. Now, it can vary depending on the type of tweed, but I find, and this is probably controversial, that tweed is easier to take care of for me than lambskin is. Tweed is one of those you buy knowing that you shouldn't wear rough fabrics with it. If you actually wear the type of clothes you should wear with a tweed bag, like soft fabrics, they're quite easy to take care of. They don't really scratch, but you have to be careful about snagging it. This type of tweed that's a more loose weave where you could get your nail under something is harder to take care of than this more flat woven tweed where you can't really get your nail under the weave here. So if you want a tweed that's more durable, you go for a more flat woven tweed. I would say I would be more comfortable wearing my flat woven tweed daily than I would my pink Chanel lambskin daily. I find that this just holds up better. A lot of people would disagree with me that lambskin leather would obviously be more durable, but I think it really depends on what lambskin or what smooth leather and what brand and what color. And tweed is just one of those that I have never had any issues with. We have lambskin or smooth leather. It depends on what brand it is, what they call this leather, but lambskin, calfskin, anything that's like smooth is next on my list because especially in colorful bags, if you get a scratch on this type of leather, it's quite noticeable. I know with Chanel lambskin, sometimes you can buff it out with like the cloth that they give you with the bag, But notice on my Celine mini luggage, it's like a gray goatskin. It really shows the scratches. And typically with lambskin, when you get a scratch, it's that if it's a deep scratch, it kind of like lifts up, if you know what I mean. It's kind of hard to describe. But when you get that lifting up effect, usually the color underneath is not the same as the top of the color for a colorful bag. I think black lambskin bags are a little more durable. They show scratches a lot less. This is a black lambskin bag that I have, and it does have some scratches and marks. Not big ones, nothing really deep, but it does hide them, especially here on the bottom. You can see the scratches, but it's not so noticeable like from afar. I think if you're gonna go for a lambskin for a daily use bag, I do recommend black, not even beige or brown. Any color in lambskin I think is more of an occasional supplemental piece for your wardrobe, but if you want a daily use, you could still get away with a black lambskin. Though it's not my top recommendation. Material on my list is velvet. Now we're getting into the more delicate materials. These are more for occasion style bags. I never recommend a velvet bag for daily use. Velvet is always very plush and supple when you first get it, and as you use it, it like wears down. Like if you think about if you have a velvet cushion in your house, or you know, a velvet blanket or something, the more you use velvet and it presses or rubs against something, the more it kind of flattens out and loses that suppleness. So this is something that I recommend only really for supplemental pieces in your wardrobe. There are also different types of velvet. The more shiny ones, the brighter color ones, are harder to take care of. This one is a little bit more of a flatter velvet. It didn't have that really, really plushy, like you can kind of tell when you touch it, if it's really, really plushy, that's something that's gonna be harder to take care of than a more like flattened out velvet. Smaller sized bags in velvet are much easier to take care of. We're almost through my list, and the last two are ones that you really have to be willing to baby your bag if you're going to have these materials and they're gonna last you a long time. Second to last on my list is python. This is genuine python, not a python print. And with genuine python, the scales can tend to lift. Now, I know exotics are not for everyone, not one who seeks out a lot of exotics, so I completely understand if you don't like exotics. For some of the people who have been asking about mine and my care tips and how to use them and how durable they are, I'm including this in the list. And the thing with python is you cannot wear rough fabrics. You need to watch your jewelry. It's an occasional use piece. It's typically quite a pricey piece depending on the brand that you get. And it's one of those that if you're not willing to baby this bag, just don't buy it. Get an imitation python print or something like that. That'll be much more durable. See a little bit here, there's a tiny bit of lifting. This naturally happens with the python bag. Some people actually like this look. I posted a TikTok about it and someone posted that the scales lifting is their favorite part about it. Most people buying a python, when you get this beautiful look, especially if you get one that's been colored in a specific way like mine has been, those scales start to lift. It's kind of like a white color underneath, so it ruins the look of the bag a little bit, in my opinion. So a lot of people want to take care of this and keep it looking like this, and to do that, you have to wear it very occasionally. You have to watch the fabrics you wear with it. You have to be very careful going in and out of it. You need to make sure you don't have makeup on your hands. You need to like really, really baby this bag. I know they look beautiful, but these are really bags that if you have a larger collection, all your base is covered. This is your like special piece that you take out very rarely. And just knowing that you're not gonna get that cost per wear out of the bag, because if you get a cost per wear out of your python bag, by the time you get there, it's not gonna look great. Next material I wanna talk about is crystals. Now, crystals can really vary depending from brand to brand and how they're put on. Glued on crystals like this are quite stuck on there usually, but the claw thing that like holds the crystals, if one gets loose and the crystal pops out, like that, you're done. Like it's easy to snag, it's easy for crystals to fall out. But this one is quite well made. I use this quite a lot, but I ranked this lower than velvet because if you're not willing to take care of your crystal bag like I am, it can ruin pretty fast. Like, let's be honest, like this is a bag you do have to baby. You do have to think about what you wear with this bag. I wouldn't wear any type of rough fabrics. You don't want something that's really going to rub and move on the crystals a lot. You want to wear it with soft fabrics if you want it to last a bit longer. Also, mine is in white. If you want a crystal bag, it's going to be more durable. The black one is definitely going to be more worry-free. Crystals are definitely something that you want to be extra careful with. These are typically higher priced bags, Like the version of this without crystals is less expensive than the crystal version. So you have to be okay with paying more and using it less. That's why I ranked this quite low, because it's something that takes a lot of care and attention, and you typically pay more for it. The material on my list is silk or satin or any of these kind of really delicate fabrics. This was probably not the best decision to get a silk bag in such a big one. I really do recommend it more for special occasions, but when I got this bag, it was one of my first Chanel bags. I didn't like think my decisions through as much in terms of material. There weren't as many resources. I got this bag around 2012 and I got it pre-loved. So Instagram reviews and bloggers really talking about handbags and materials weren't really a thing then, so I didn't have the same education. I'm glad I got pre-loved and I got a good deal on it, because it's one that I don't use often. And this is, again, one that you want to wear only with like softer material clothing. You want to be careful with your jewelry. If you snag this, you have to think of it like a silk scarf. Like, if you snag the silk, there's no going back. There's nothing you can do to repair the bag. It's not one that you should be buying for daily use. They look beautiful. They're great supplemental pieces in a wardrobe, but silk and satin are not materials I recommend for someone with a small collection, or someone who's looking for that hard-wearing bag, or someone who's not willing to baby their bag. You also have to be really careful about water stains. You can't wear this when it's raining. This is one that definitely you have to be willing to really do the work to take care of it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful for you. This was really based on my own personal experience and use of my handbags. Let me know what you agreed with, what you disagreed with in the comments, and your personal experience. If you find one of these leathers or materials more durable than I did, let me know how you care for it, or if you have any tips for it. Let's talk about this in the comments and help each other out. I think that use and how you use it and what climate you live in can really play a role in how you would do your own ranking. If you're a creator yourself, I would love to see you do a video similar to this and rank leathers in your personal experience, because I think we can all learn from this as a community. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram to see how I style my bags and my daily looks. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.